हेलो
मैम अभी आई विल इनवाइट यू मैम
ओके
या काइंडली गो अहेड
ओके गुड इवनिंग एवरीवन माय सेल्फ कर्णिका गौड लाइब्रेरियन कालिंदी कॉलेज ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ कालिंदी कॉलेज लाइब्रेरी आई वेलकम यू ऑल टू दिस अवेयरनेस प्रोग्राम ऑन नेशनल डिजिटल लाइब्रेरी ऑफ इंडिया थैंक यू ऑल फॉर जॉइनिंग विद अस टुडे दिस अवेयरनेस प्रोग्राम विल बी बेनिफिशियल टू ऑल ऑफ यू Today we have with us our distinguished speaker, Dr. Vignesh Sornamohan, who is the Chief Strategic and Outreach Officer at National Digital Library of India, IIT Kharagpur. We also have with us our Honorable Principal Madam, Dr. Anjula Bansal, who always encourages us and inspires us to organize such programs. I welcome you both for happily agreeing to grace this program by taking out time from your busy schedule. I would also like to express my sense of gratitude to all the participants without whom this program would not have seen the light of this day. Now I would request our principal madam, Dr. Anjula Bansal, to give an inaugural address. Ma'am, please.
Okay, thank you, Karnika. Good evening to everybody. Respected Dr. Vignesh, Chief Strategic and Outreach Officer, National Digital Library of India, IIT Kharagpur, West Bengal, Dr. Karnika, dear colleagues and students, good evening to all of you. It gives me immense pleasure to welcome you all to this webinar on awareness program on National Digital Library of India, NDLI, organized by Kalindi College, in association with National Digital Library of India under Ministry of Human Resource Development, Government of India and IIT Kharagpur. Ministry of National Mission on Education through Information and Communication Technology has initiated the National Digital Library of India project to develop a framework of virtual repository of learning resources with a single window search facility. Filtered and federated searching is employed to facilitate focused searching so that learners can find out the right resource with least effort and in minimum time. It is being developed to help students to prepare for entrance and competitive examinations to enable people to learn and prepare for best practices all over the world and to facilitate researchers to perform interlinked exploration from multi sources. It is being developed at IIT Kharagpur. The National Digital Library of India is an all digital library that stores information about different of digital contents, including books, articles, videos, audios, theses, and other educational materials relevant for the users from varying educational levels and capabilities. It provides a single window search facility so that learners can retrieve the right resources with the least effort in minimum time. NDLI is designed to hold content of any language and provide interface support for the leading vernacular languages. It is available on all popular forms of access devices, including mobile apps on Android and iOS platforms. NDLI has been designed to benefit all kinds of users, like students of all levels, teachers, researchers, librarians, library users, professionals, differently abled users, and all other lifelong learners. NDLI is certainly different from other digital libraries. NDLI will provide a single window search facility to act as a one-stop shop for all digital educational resources. Information can be personalized based on the education level, choice of language, difficulty level, media of content, and such other factors. While other digital libraries may not include all these choices and facilities, NDLI provides interface support for the leading vernacular languages, and thus one can select the language of his or her choice to search or browse through NDLI. In other words, it is like a customized service provided in a 24/7 integrated environment to suit a user's requirement, and will be like a single go-to shop for any requirement. At last, I will not talk more about it because we will listen from the speaker now. At last, I would like to thank the organizers of the webinar, Dr. Karnika Gaur, and her entire team for organizing this webinar. I am sure that this webinar would be a good learning experience for all of us. I convey my best wishes for the success of this webinar. Stay home, stay safe and healthy. Thank you. Thank you to all.
Karnika, your mic is mute.
Karnika, ma'am, you are on mute.
Okay, now I'm audible?
Yes.
You are audible.
Okay, sorry for the trouble. Thank you, ma'am, for your kind words. Now I would like to invite Dr. Vignesh to present his presentation. Before that, I would like to give a brief introduction about Dr. Vignesh. He is a Chief Strategic and Outreach Officer at India National Digital Library of India. He holds a PhD from the Center for the Study of Law and Governance, JNU, with a Master's in Public Management. He is also the founder of Brilliant IAS Prepare, a mobile-based low-cost training solution for the civil service aspirants. Earlier to this, he worked with Indian Public Library Movements and CSCE Governance Services India Limited. Dr. Vignesh has managed large developed projects like National Digital Literacy Mission, CyberGram, Yojana, e-inclusion, that is IT training for SC/ST women beneficiaries, e-Vidya, innovative project for rural women, women digital literacy projects, child labor family linkage projects, financial literacy and investor awareness, legal literacy, tele-ophthalmology, digital diagnostic kits, and telemedicine centers. On behalf of Kalindi College, I welcome you once again and invite you to enlighten us all about the National Digital Library of India. Over to you, Dr. Vignesh.
Thank you, Dr. Karnika, respected principal, madam, and the representatives of Kalindi College, Delhi University. We are very pleased to be here, and thank you for hosting us and create awareness about National Digital Library of India to your college students, and as well as I could see some outside participants as well. So without wasting much time, let's directly get into the presentation. So is the my audio as well as the presentation clear? If yes, kindly put it in the chat.
Yeah.
Okay. Sure. So let's start. So in today's session, we are going to look at six important information. One is why NDLI was created, and who is this part, and what kind of content we have at NDLI, how to access NDLI, and what is the difference between Google and NDLI, and how to operate NDLI Club in your own institution. So these are the six things that we are going to look at in today's session. So let's start with the first question, which is why NDLI was created on the first place. So if you look at this map of India, though it's slightly outdated, and this is as per the 2011 census, the literacy, it shows the literacy level of the country as per the 2011 census. If you look at this map, except very few states like Kerala, Goa, Tripura and Mizoram, where the literacy level is above 90%, but majority of the states, the literacy level, if you look at these light pinkish color, you can see the literacy level in these states are less than 75%. So this is one official statistics. On the other hand, we have another official statistics which says every month at least 1 million people, that is 10 lakh people, are turning into 18 years of age. That means they are at an age wherein they can they can get into the higher educational institutions. So if we have to address this educational need, India needs to set up 6 universities and 270 colleges every month for the next 20 years. Then only we will be able to address this emerging educational pyramid. This may not be in one specific spaces, like for example in Tamil Nadu we have excess colleges. Similarly, in some part of Karnataka, we have more number of where the demand is less, the supply is more. So we need educational institution, higher educational institutions set up in various states of this country, especially those countries where states where there is a need. So even if we set up these, the government is taking up initiatives to set up a lot of educational institutions. But this requires huge amount of human financial resources, right? And 20 continuous years. So that would need a huge amount of investment. And if you ask me, are these brick and mortar structure will be sustainable in the long run? We really don't know, because we have already seen in many parts of the country, the educational institutions are closing down. Due to multiple reasons. One of the reasons are like they don't have a good number of intake by the students. So that is one of the reasons. So the government of India looked at alternative supplementary and complementary learning resource platforms, like you might have already heard of NPTEL, Swayam, Swayamprabha, NDLI, Gyan. So all these are supplementary and complementary learning resource materials, which the government of India conceived and started implementing, not now, maybe like between 2014-15, the government like aggressively started pushing these initiatives. And apart from this, if you look at why this virtual library is required, though we have more than 2 lakh libraries, physical libraries across the country, why do we need a virtual or a digital library in the first case? So if you look at the situation now, especially in the last few years, 5 to 7 years, the budget, financial allocation and the human resource allocation for the libraries has been drastically reduced. So I'm not aware of the situation in the Delhi University or in your own campus, but in majority of the institutions, the library budget has been drastically reduced. Say, for example, suppose if an average institution spends about 10 lakh rupees before 5 years, now that has come down to 2 lakh rupees. Similarly, if they were like 10 human resources to manage that library, now only 1 or 2% may be managing the same library. So that's the situation. So what does the team play? When you reduce financial and human resources for libraries, what does that lead to? It means you are having less number of quality knowledge resources, when you have like less number of quality knowledge resources and also less number of human resources to like take power these resources, the access to quality knowledge resources to the faculty members and the students are getting hampered. When the quality knowledge resources are not unavailable to faculty members and students, it results in poor learning outcomes. So it's all a vicious cycle that is interconnected. And that is one major reason we are looking at now. And also, in the recent past, we have come across this physical infrastructure, lack of additional physical infrastructure as another major challenge before the physical libraries. See, for example, many of the institutions where we visited, we could see like these libraries can easily host about 1 lakh resources, but they already have more than 2 lakh resources. So where do they find space to like stack these resources? So yeah, we've seen in some of the places these resources are lying on the top of some rack or like lies on the corridors of the library. So these are the scenes that we can see in many of the physical libraries. And the third reason why NDLI is required, say for example, if there is a good authored book and your faculty member has suggested to you to read, the entire class to read, so how many persons can access it at the same time? So maybe already one more faculty member might have already got it issued in his or her name. And most of the times when it's issued to a faculty member, it takes time to get back to the library. So we have experienced this in our student life. And also accessing the same resource by multiple persons, then we ultimately end up in photocopying these resources. So say for example, I remember I used to spend anywhere between at least 1,000 to few thousand rupees in only photocopying the resources. Whether we study it or not, we do photocopy religiously. So that's another reason why digital library is required. And also we could see like interesting situations where the students or the resources are missing or hidden or damaged. So these things we have already seen in the physical library. So the government of India looked at all these situations. So they wanted to identify a solution. They wanted to give quality knowledge resources to every Indian citizen without any bias. So they wanted to actually democratize the education. So they wanted to give knowledge resources at their fingertips. So that is when National Digital Library of India was launched as a pilot project in 2016. And it was dedicated to the nation as a national knowledge asset on 19 June 2018. By the then MHRD Minister Shri Prakash Javadekar. So now let's look at what do we have at NDLI. At NDLI, we primarily store only the metadata. We only ingest metadata. What is metadata? Metadata is nothing but data about data in technical terms, right? In definition terms, metadata is nothing but data about data. But in this context, metadata is nothing but the basic information about a resource. The resource could be a book or an article or a thesis or a research project, right? Or say law judgments, law act. So the basic information, say for example, if it's a book, what is the title of the book? Who is the author? Who is the publisher? What are the subject categories it is touching upon? What is the abstract? So the basic information about a book is called metadata, okay? So here in this context, the metadata, we only store the basic information about the resources, right? Then you may ask me like, where do the full text come from? So I will show you this diagram. So if you look at this diagram, imagine this central part, the server kind of an icon. This is the National Digital Library of India's portal. Okay. So first, what we do is, say for example, if Kalindi College has 1,000 non-copyrighted, open source digitized resources, okay? And they wanted to share these resources with the entire country. So in that case, what we do is we sign up an agreement with Kalindi College, and then we help them in setting up an IDR, that is Institutional Digital Repository. We follow DSpace. And then we help them in moving their 1,000 non-copyrighted open digital resources into that idea. Once that is moved, we also help them in, simultaneously we help them in creating the metadata. Metadata, as I said, basic information about those 1,000 resources. Once that is created, we only pull the metadata from Kalindi College's IDR, and then we store it in our NDLI repository. Right? Now, if a researcher from, say, Kerala wants to access the resources of Kalindi College, so he comes to NDLI, he searches for some resource that was published by Kalindi College. So we redirect him to Kalindi College's IDR. IDR is nothing but a technical small server. We redirect him, and we IDR of Kalindi College verifies it's an authentic user. If it's authentic, then, and if it's a full text resource, the entire full text is given to the researcher directly. Right? So this is how we operate. And there is a reason behind this, why it is being done. Because at this point in time, so suppose if any resource that comes under copyright violation or a copyrighted material that comes onto NTLA, then like we might end up in legal battle. So in order to avoid this, we have avoided storing any full text in our server. So it is primarily coming from our partners. So we primarily work through the partners. So we have, as I mentioned, we don't create any content, or we don't digitize any content. We primarily work through content partners. So we have like closer to 308 content contributors. You name any major educational research and publishing partners. Also some private sector players also have come up and shared their resources with NDLI. Now let's see what type of content we have at NDLI. So we have computer science, information and general works, closer to 1 crore resources. Philosophy and psychology, we have 5 lakh resources. Religion, 2 lakh resources. Social sciences, 45 lakh resources. Language, 1 lakh resources. Natural sciences and mathematics, 65 lakh resources. Sorry, that's 85 lakh resources. Technology, 1 crore resources. The arts, fine and decorative arts, 4.5 lakh resources. Literature and rhetoric, 7.9 lakh resources. History and geography, 6.14 lakh resources. So if you add these, you will get 4.8 plus crore resources. So that is the, as of today, we have 4.8 crore resources. And what are these resources? So these resources range of, we have a range of resources, starting from faculty publications, thesis, dissertation, master's project, undergraduate projects, books, periodicals, open access journals, e-books, annual reports, PowerPoint presentations, video lectures, audio lectures, class notes, courseware, term papers, assignments, assessments, solutions, data sets, manuscripts, paintings. So we have a range of resources, and we have closer to around, I think, 60 different types of learning resources at NDL. And these 4.8 resources are in 5 different access mode. So what are those 5 different access mode, and why are they created? The first 5 different access option mode is open resources. So it means these resources are available in open market. That can be, full text can be accessed, right? And the second resource, which is called NDL access option, is NDL user. So these resources are primarily the national license resources. So Government of India has procured national license, and that has given to Indian citizens who are registered at NDLI. If you are registered at NDLI, you can avail, say for example, South Asia Archives resources at free of cost. So that is specifically for NDL users. And then limited access means, suppose if there is a 30-page article, out of which only 10 or 15 page may be accessible, the remaining pages may not be accessible. That's a third different access option. And the fourth access option is subscribe. So I will give you an example. For example, Springer. We only, for Springer or IEEE, we only have the metadata. Suppose if your institution has subscribed to Springer or IEEE, Then when you click this resources from your IP address, then it will check whether you have your institution has subscribed it up. Suppose if your institution has subscribed it, then it will give you the full text resources. Otherwise, it may not. You will be able to see only the metadata. And the last one is restricted, which is the they only have closed access that is not available for outside users. So these are the five different access options available at NDLA. Now let's see access option wise content. So I told you there are five different access options. The first one is open resource, open type of resources. We have 2.79 pro resources as open resources. And the second one I told you was NDLA users. So 77.94 lakh resources are NDLA users. So if you add these two, 3.54 crore resources are full text resources. So what is the meaning of full text resources? Full text resources means you can actually download these resources and use these resources at free of cost for educational and research purposes. Or in another words, you can put it as non-commercial purposes. These are not, these resources are primarily for educational and research purposes only. So that means 73% of our resources are full text resources. And these resources are meant for every age group, starting from the school going children to college going youths, working professionals, academicians, researchers, lifelong learners, entrepreneurs, anyone who is interested in learning, we have the resources for everyone. Now let's look at how to access NDLA. Just give me a moment. There is some. Okay, so accessing NDLA is very simple. What you have to do is go to Google or any browser for that matter, and then search for National Digital Library of India. Put the entire word, and the first URL you will get this ndl.iitkgp.ac.in. This is our URL. So you just have to click on this URL. Once you click, it will take you to our home page. This is our home page looks like. So here you can see on the top left corner, you can see browse and then search. And then you can here you can see language, and then this is login. So here at the center, if you can see this white box, this is the search box. So here you have to put the search keyword. So like here, for example, I put Hindi literature. And this section of this this section has been created by our team during this lockdown period. So you can see we have classified our resources into various educational and educational level and domains. School, CBSE examination preparatory materials, engineering materials, science related materials, humanities, literature, law and management. And also our team has classified the resources, related resources on COVID-19 research as well. And also we have some featured collections. So this is the home page. So suppose if I want to search on Hindi literature, so I typed Hindi literature and then I clicked on search. So once I clicked on search, it took me to this page. So this is the page. So here I did, what I did was I changed the language interface. So you can actually change this language interface into various Indian languages. So here I've changed it into Hindi. So I clicked here and then I chose Hindi. You can see this entire interface now has been changed to Hindi. Earlier it was in English. I will show you how the English version looks like. So now I searched for Hindi literature and I wanted it in the language of Hindi itself. So I chose, so there is, so these things are called filters. So there are at least some 11 filters which are available at NDLA through which you can narrow down your results. So this filter called language, I chose Hindi. I got 8,665 results on this topic of Hindi literature in Hindi language. And the next topic I searched was on history of Delhi. But now I wanted the resources. I wanted only the thesis available on this topic of history of Delhi. So what I did was I went to source. So there is a source of InfibNet Shodh Ganga. Shodh Ganga is nothing but the repository of all Indian theses. And Shodh Gangotri is the dissertations, the repository of dissertations. Suppose if you are going to search on a topic called history of Delhi, and you wanted to know what are the theses that are already available, or else what are the research that has already been done on this topic. Like it's like a literature review. So I searched on history of Delhi, and then I chose InfibNet Shodh Ganga from the source. I got 66 results, theses on this topic of history of Delhi alone. So similarly, if you want to search on a topic of your research, you can go here and search for the topic. And the next topic I searched was on financial accounting. And now I wanted only video lectures on this topic of financial accounting. So what I did was I searched financial accounting. On the right hand side, we have a filter called content type. Here I clicked on video. So there is this video symbol. I just clicked on video. I got 1,727 videos on this topic of financial accounting. So for using NDLE, you need to remember two important things. One is the search keyword, that you have to choose the right keyword without any spelling mistakes. So that is one. And the second one is you need to know the various filter options through which you can narrow down the result. So I will talk about these filter options in a little while. Now the next topic I searched was on pedagogy of science. So here I went to a source called TeacherTube. I wanted it from a resource called TeacherTube. I got 84,941 results on this topic of pedagogy of science alone. And then I searched on a topic called theory of relativity. Now I wanted only lectures or video lessons from NPTEL. So some of you might already know what does NPTEL stands for. So go to source and then click NPTEL videos. I got 51 results on this topic of theory of relativity alone. Here you can see various authors publish these resources. And the next topic I searched was on artificial intelligence. Here I applied three filters. First is I chose access restriction. I wanted only open resource. Second, I chose subject category. I wanted it from computer science and technology only. And the third one, I wanted it from the source of MIT open courseware alone, not from anyone else. I got 64 results on this topic of artificial intelligence. And the next topic I searched was on human physiology. Again, I wanted only the video lecture. So I got 12,788 results on this topic of human physiology. And the next topic was on biochemistry, Java programming, and then rural marketing. So we have resources on a range of topics, and I will give you a few minutes after this presentation to explore what are the kind of resources available. So now I will show you how to access these study at home resources. So go to the home page, and then suppose if you want science or humanities or literature resources, what you can do is you can just click on the relevant section. So first I clicked on humanities. Once you click on humanities, it will take you to this page. It will show you what are the subject domains that are available under humanities. So you have general resources, history, geography, sociology, economics, psychology, political science, education, constitution and law, philosophy, mass communication, library science, music and film studies. So this is humanities. And then science, agriculture, atmospheric science, biology and biotechnology, chemistry and biochemistry, computer science, environmental science, mathematics, nanotechnology and physics. And then literature, study of English literature, Hindi literature, Sanskrit, Urdu, literary works in English. Okay, now I will show you how to download a resource from NDLN. So you search for a topic, research methodology, and I wanted it from a specific source of Lovely Professional University. So I chose Lovely Professional University from source. I got 1,438 results. Now, suppose if I want to open this first resource, go to this first resource and then just click. Once you click, it will take you to this page. So here on the top left corner, you can see two tabs, content and metadata. Content and metadata. First, click on metadata. So this information, this is called metadata. So this is the title, research methodology, source is Lovely Professional University, content type is text, publisher is Excel Books Private Limited, file format is PDF, language is English. Suppose if you find this resource useful, then you have to look at access restriction. So here it is an open resource. It means you can actually download these resources and use it for educational purposes. And the third thing you need to notice is whether you have already logged in or not. So here on the top right corner, you can see I've already logged in with my user ID and password. So I can see my name is already there. Now, if you click on this content button, then the entire 338 pages of content will get downloaded into your desktop or laptop or mobile phone. Now you can study, take a printout, or share it with your friends, family members, or relatives. It's completely free of cost. And the only condition is it should be non-commercial purpose. It should be educational and research purposes only, right? Imagine you have not logged in. So here on the top right corner, you can see it's not, my name is not showing. It means I have not logged in. Now, if you click on content, it will take you to this page. It will ask you to please log in to view this content. So then what you need to do is click on this login at the center. Once you click, this pop-up window will appear. So here it will ask you for your email ID and password and also ask you to enter the CAPTCHA. Once you enter the CAPTCHA, then you can click on login. Then you can download these resources. Imagine you registered at NDLA a couple of months back or a couple of years back and you forgot your password, but you remember your registered email ID. In that case, what you can do is you click on this account recovery button. Once you click on this account recovery, this pop-up window will appear. So here you just have to enter your email ID and then click submit. Once you submit, you will get a password reset URL email with information how to do it. So you just have to follow the instructions and then reset your password and then come back, enter your email ID and enter your new password and then enter the CAPTCHA and log in. And imagine this is the first time you are using NDLA and you have never heard about it and this is the first time but you want to access it. In that case, you have to just click on this register, then this form, registration form, will open. Enter the basic information and then you will get a, once you submit, you will get a verification email. Then you can just have to click on verification URL, then your account will get activated, then you can download and use the resources. For browsing, you don't have to log into the account. Once you want to download the resource or you want to view the information, then it will ask you to log into the NDLA portal, then only you will be able to see the resources. Suppose if it's a video lecture, this is how the video lecture will open. So as I told you, for using NDLA, you need to remember two important things. First is the search keyword and the second one is the filter options. So there are some 11 filters that are available. Here I'm going to talk about some 8 important filters. What are those 8 important filters? Access restriction. Access restriction filter means, suppose if you want only full text resources, so click on access restriction, choose open and NDLA, then you will get only the full text resources. What does full text resources mean? It means you can download the entire resource, book or article, and then use it for educational purposes. And the second one is author. You searched on a topic and you wanted it from a specific author called Wisam. So you just have to go and choose the specific author. And the third one is subject category. You searched on a topic and you wanted it only and from the computer science domain. Say for example, you wanted a resource on object-oriented programming, but you wanted it only from computer science domain. So you just have to click on computer science. And the next filter option is file format. Suppose if you want only PDF files. Go to file format and then choose PDF files. And then language. So at NDLI, we have resources in more than 300, both Indian as well as international languages. So you suppose if you want resources only in Hindi language, go to language filter and then type Hindi, then you will be able to see the resources in Hindi. And the sixth filter option is learning resource type. So we have, as I mentioned earlier, we have more than 60 different types of learning resource materials that are available at NDLI. Suppose if you want only photographs, go here and choose photographs. Suppose if you want only audiobooks, go to audiobook and choose. And the seventh filter option is source. So as I told you, there are 308 content contributors. All these content contributors come under this filter of source. Suppose if you want the resources only from Bloomsbury, so go to source and then choose Bloomsbury. You will get resources only from Bloomsbury. Suppose if you want resources only from Bangalore University, go here and choose Bangalore University. And the last filter option, which is available only in the desktop application, which is content type. This is available on the right hand side. So suppose if you want only video lectures, choose video. Suppose if you want audio, just choose audio. Depending on the content requirement, you can narrow down the search by using these filter options. So as I mentioned, you can actually change the entire NDLI interface into your own mother tongue as well. So currently you can change the entire interface into Bangla, Hindi, Marathi, Gujarati, Kannada, Odia, Tamil, Malayalam, Assamese, and Punjabi is also underway. And for ease of use, we also have mobile app, which is available on both Android as well as iOS. So you can go to Play Store if you are using an Android phone, or if you are using an iPhone, go to the iStore and then search for National Digital Library of India. You have to enter the entire name of the app, National Digital Library of India. Then you will see this logo, app name, and the publisher. All the three should be National Digital Library of India. Then you can install the app in your mobile phone. Now I will show you how to use NDLI Android app. So once you install the app from Play Store, then you just have to click on this app. Then this is the home page of NDLI Android. So you can see subject domain wise content, learning resource type wise content, featured resources. Now if you want to search in the mobile app, then what you need to do is click on this search icon, then this search box will appear. Okay, so here you can enter the search keyword and then click search from your keypad. Then this will display the results. So I searched for a topic called Uttar Pradesh, and I got 41,573 results on this topic of Uttar Pradesh. Now, if you want to filter in the desktop application, you had the filter options on the left hand side and on the right hand side, but whereas in the mobile app, this filter option is available on the right bottom corner. This orange color icon, this is the filter option. So once you click on this icon, then all the filter options which we saw on the desktop application will start displaying on the top. Okay, so you can actually scroll down to see the remaining filter options. Now I wanted the resources. I applied to a filter called source and I wanted the resources only from Aligarh Muslim University. So I chose Aligarh Muslim University and then clicked apply. I got 199 results. So this is how we need to use the NDLI Android. So before we move into the next part of the presentation, I'm going to give you a small activity. The activity is nothing but I want you to do two things. One is I want you to install the NDLI mobile app. If you have already installed, brilliant. Suppose if you have not installed the NDLI app, kindly install it in your mobile phone. That is part one. And the second part is I want you to search on a topic which is of relevance to you, whether it could be a subject of study or a subject of teaching or it's subject of interest. You search for a topic and see how many resources are available on this topic and whether it is useful or not. So I'm going to give you 5 minutes to you for doing this activity. Now it's 6:46 in my system. So we will take time till 6:51. So kindly do these two activities. First one is kindly install the app. And the second one is search for a topic which is of relevance to you. And then in the chat box, kindly put it whether you install the app and which topic you searched and how many results you found on this topic. So your time starts now. Good, Niksha. If you've installed the app, kindly search for a topic of your interest. And then in the chat box, kindly put which topic you searched and how many results you found and whether it is useful or not. Dr. Rini has installed the app. Very good. So how many of you have installed? So Ms. Ritu Gupta has installed. I installed the app. My topic was innovative words in English. The result was 2,79,000 results. Good. Dr. Priyanka has installed. Installed, Anjali installed, Dr. Priyanka Bituri installed. Oh, kindly let me know which topic you searched. Okay, Divya searched on Article 370. Mrs. Manasi Rege installed app. Kindly mute your mic, please. Okay. India's freedom struggle.
Yes, sir. Mrs. Mansi Rege.
No, no, it's okay. I was just reading your.
I got 39.
No, I was just reading your message. That's it. Nothing. Human physiology. Dr. Rojana searched on human physiology. Asta Sautri installed the app. Search for investing behavior. Sonia, Ms. Sonia Kamboj installed an investing behavior on stock markets. And Anjali searched on genetics. Dr. Sushmita Chatterjee. Installed on bio, searched on biochemistry. Sumanish Jasrotia searched on heavy metals. Just one more minute. Ms. Manleen Kaur searched on history of India. Dr. Niti searched on business laws. Dr. Swati searched on coordination chemistry. She found 92,000 results. Okay, brilliant. So you've done a good job. That's wonderful. So it's just a beginning that you've started now. What I want you to do is, after this webinar is over, I want you to spend at least 15 minutes, right? 15 minutes of your time in searching what are the topics that you want to know the results. And then just put all the topic which that comes to your mind and see whether these resources, whether you have the resources at NDLA or not. If it's there, whether it is useful for you or not. If it's useful, can it be useful for your friends, relatives, students, colleagues? So if you find it useful, kindly share it with them. And you just take in, out of 15 minutes, just spend 5 minutes in spreading this information to at least 100 people that are in touch with you. They could be your students, your colleagues, your friends, relatives, family members. So kindly do that. So that's the service that you can do to this nation. My humble request to you as well. Okay, so now, thank you, Dr. Swajit. You searched on physical chemistry. That's wonderful. So thank you so much, everyone. Now we will get back to the session. So now we will see what is the difference between Google and NDLA with the help of an example. Imagine there is a girl called Payal who is studying in class 8 and her language, native language is Hindi. She wants to know about magnetism in the subject of physics. And there is another guy called Shamik who wants to pursue his PhD on this topic of magnetism. Now, both of them have gone to Google and they searched for this topic called magnetism and they got 1.89 crore results, right? They got, both of them got the same results. Now they came to NDLA and they searched for the same topic, magnetism, and they got 11.16 lakh resources. Both of them got the same results. Now, what Payal did was she applied two filters. The first filter she applied was educational level and the second filter she applied was language and she got only 8 results relevant for her. And what Shami did was he chose only career and technical papers and he got 219 results. Imagine where is 1.89 crore and where is 8 and 219 results. So now let's see what is the difference between Google and NDLA from this example. So before we get into this, let's understand how Google functions. So the moment you put a search term, so here we put a search term called magnetism, what Google does is it goes around the entire world wide web and wherever this term called magnetism is stored, it pulls the results and displays it in front of you, right? And in this process, that's a brilliant job. It does its job seamlessly. It brings to you like in no matter of time. And say for example, whereas in this process, what Google can't do is it can't distinguish whether it is coming from an authentic source or an authentic source, whether it is a real information or a fake information, whether it is educational content or non-educational content, whether it is relevant for Payal or Shamik or Vignesh, it can't distinguish. It treats everyone equally and it pulls the resource. On the other hand, what NDLA does is we primarily work through partners. And who are these partners? They are primarily educational institutions or research institutions or publishing partners or some private sector players. And all these content which we have, 4.8 crore resources, are curated educational content. And the second difference between Google and NDLA is you can actually narrow down the results using the filter option. This can be done in Google as well, but Google filters advanced search option is slightly generic in nature, whereas our filter options are specifically targeted at educational fields. And the third difference is you can modify the search based on the content type. And the fourth one is national licensing. So I already told you the government of India has procured a couple of national licenses and it's giving free access to these resources to NDLI registered users, which is not available at Google. So these are the major difference between Google and NDLI. So now we will see the last part of the presentation, which is how to operate NDLI club in your own institution. So why NDLI club is required? So the objective behind starting NDLI club is two. What are those twin objectives? The first one is to promote the culture of reading. That's one of the important requirements of today's young age population. And also we have a second objective, which is to take forward these knowledge resources of NDLI to every Indian citizen. So these are the twin objectives of NDLI club. And for achieving that objectives, so we have to form a club with members. So how this composition could be? It could be at least one student from each class and one faculty member from each department, with a librarian or faculty member or NSS coordinator as the ex officio secretary and principal as the ex officio chairman of the club. So once you form this club, get this list approved by the head of the institution, and then you have to apply for this NDLI club registration. So this is how the NDLI club registration form looks like. So it will capture the basic information about your institution, and then you have to attach the list of NDLI club members and then submit. Once you submit this application, this application will come to us and we will do a back-end verification of your institution. And if it meets our requirement, then we will issue a certificate of registration. So this certificate of registration, this is how it looks like. This is valid for 1 year. And within that 1 year, you are required to do two activities. What are those two activities? The first activity is register all the students and faculty members of your institution within 30 days of receipt of the certificate. And the second part is you need to conduct at least 10 reading or knowledge related activities in the remaining period. So these are the two tasks that you need to do once you receive the certificate. Now let us see how to do the registration part. So the registration can be done in two ways. One is the individual registration, wherein anyone can go to NDLI website and create an account, or you can also do bulk registration. So we encourage especially the higher education institutions to go for bulk registration, because when you apply for NAC accreditation or AICT affiliation or NBA accreditation, so that time they will ask you for the digital learning resource that you are using. So suppose if you put NDLI as your digital learning resource, then they will, when they come for the visit, that time they will ask how many students registered and how many faculty members registered and how many of them have activated their account. Suppose if your students and faculty members registered as individuals, then you may not be able to show them under your college category. So for that purpose, you can encourage your students and faculty members to do a bulk registration. So now I will show you how to do the bulk registration. For bulk registration, what you need to do is capture three details of each student and faculty member. What are those three details? Their personal email ID, first name and last name, only three details. Put it in an Excel sheet and then send it to our email ID. So that is, what is our email ID? ndl-support@iitkgp.ac.in. This is our official email ID. And just mark a copy to me so that I can follow up with our team to get it done quickly. So my email ID is vignesh@ndl.gov.in or vigneshjnu@gmail.com. So both the email IDs work. So once you send the list to us, we will do a bulk registration of them, and they will all get a automated email with a URL to activate their account. So they just have to follow the process and activate their account. So this is the most important part. This is how you need to register. Suppose if you want to do an individual registration, right? Then what you can do is go to the NDLI homepage. On the top right corner, you can see this login button. So just click on this login button. This pop-up window will appear. So suppose if you want to register as individual, just click on this register. Once you click on this register, this registration form will open. It will capture basic information, your full name, your email ID, password, confirm password, date of birth, gender, state, city, educational role, language, institute name, CAPTCHA, choose the terms and condition and sign up. So this entire form will not take more than 5 minutes for you to fill. So just fill the form and then sign up. Then you will get a verification email. Just follow the process. So this is how the registration has to be done. So either you can do an individual registration or do a bulk registration. So now let's see the second part of the task that you need to do. Conduct at least 10 reading related activities. So these could be a lecture series or a quiz competition or a storytelling session or a go fish session, film screening, drawing competition, role play, writing competition, make a space or debate. So these are just indicative list of activities. The club members can come up with their own reading or knowledge related activities, and also they can come up with an inter-college activity or a competition as well. So this is up to the club members. The primary purpose is to bring back the culture of reading among the young population. And then you need to upload the activities. So these are some of the activities being conducted by various NDLA clubs across the country. So this is it from my end. And if you have any questions, you can put it in the chat box. I will respond to your questions. Over to Dr. Karnika.
Thank you, Dr. Vignesh. Anyone has any questions? I think there was one. Could you explain the process of registration? I think it has already been done for you. I don't think so. I think you have explained so well. I think there are no questions. Anybody, any question? You can write in the chat
Hello.
Box, please.
Hello.
Write in the chat box, please.
Chat box.
They want to provide the links one again.
Which link they want? Sorry, I muted you by mistake.
No issues.
Yes.
Mansi, which link you want?
Oh, feedback link. So that this.
You will get it. You'll get it.
Dr. Karnika will share it in the process. So if there are not much questions, then over to Dr. Karnika.
Yeah, sure.
Mamta, there is a question from Mamta Sharma. Why all the institution has to register this NTL? So it's not mandatory, Ms. Mamta. So anyone who sees value, they can use it. It's a Government of India initiative. And we have 4.8 crore resources. And we have resources in various subjects and various educational level in various format. If you find it useful, you can use it. And if you like really love it, then you spread the message. That's the request we are having. We are not enforcing it on anyone. If you don't like it, just leave it. Searching the material again. So Dr. Rajini is requesting, can you tell the process of searching the material again? So Dr. Rajini, what you need to do is, suppose if you are using a mobile app, install the mobile app, open the mobile app. On the top, you will see a search icon. Just click on that search icon. Then the text box, the search box will appear. There you enter the search keyword and then click on search from your keypad. Then you will be able to see the results on the page. Suppose if you want to apply the filters, on the bottom right corner, you will see an orange color icon. Just click there, then you will be able to like see the results. Suppose if you want to use the search from the desktop application, from your laptop or your desktop, then go to the NDLA homepage, and then on the top you will see the on the center you will see a search box. Just enter the search keyword and then click search. Then for filtering, you will see the filter options on the both the sides, left and right hand side. You can narrow down the filters. Ms. Ritu Gupta is asking, if you want to search individually, can we get the material easily? Yes, you will get. Okay. Sure.
Registration link.
We have the subscription of the NDLA, but all the users have to register in the NDLA. Yes, so basically this is primarily to avoid or create what you call security mechanism. Say for example, we came across a situation wherein one copyright violation occurred, right? And we suppose if individual students or individual members are not registered, and if you don't have their details, then the entire initiative is about to be flame. So for primarily from the security point of view, it is important to have each one registered. Otherwise, like some of the institutions are getting like one email ID and password for accessing the entire resource. That may be available in some of them, but not with the NDLA, because our initiative is having a different connotation to it. Okay, so over to Dr. Karnika.
I think Dr. Vignesh, you had the access for the feedback, I think, remember?
Let me just check.
Yeah, because it's from my side, it's not showing as active because I made you the admin, I think. I don't know why it is showing that.
I think you created that form.
No issues, otherwise we'll send, because we have the information, otherwise we'll send it, the feedback form. If it's not working right now, I'll send it through the email. So don't worry about it.
So let me check if even feedback.
It is working. Some Sonia has failed, I think. Not working. What's happening?
Maybe in the settings you have put only something like that. Let me just check.
No, it's yeah, it was shared with you. So.